Hello, in this video section, we will discuss plane wave solution. In the last lecture, we have discussed wave equation for plane wave. The wave equation for electric field is del square E minus epsilon mu del square E by del t square is equal to 0, or del square E minus 1 by b square del square E by del t square is equal to 0, where b equal to 1 by square root of epsilon mu. Epsilon is the permittivity of the medium and mu is the permeability of the medium. The medium is linear, homogeneous and isotropic dielectric medium. Similarly, the wave equation for magnetic field is del square B minus epsilon mu del square B by del t square is equal to 0, or del square B minus 1 by B square del square B by del t square is equal to 0. So these are the wave equation for electric field and magnetic field respectively. Let us solve equation 1. So solving for electric field E, one method is that is method of complex analysis, which is easier to solve this type of equation. So electric field is that is time harmonic, it changes with time. So we can write E of RT is equal to E of R into e to the power minus I omega T. So this is time harmonic field. Omega is the angular frequency. This omega that is angular frequency. So now using this in equation 1, we have del square E of R e to the power minus I omega T minus 1 by B square del square by del T square of E of R into e to the power minus I omega T is equal to 0. So we know that a del square Laplacian operator, so it can be operates on E of R, and e to the power minus I omega T is independent of del square, so that is taken outside. E to the power minus I omega T del square E of R minus 1 by B square, so E of R is taken outside of del square of del T square, that is independent of time. So this is E of R, and derivative of del square and derivative del square by del t square of e to the minus I omega t is equal to 0, or e to the minus I omega t del square E of R minus 1 by V square E of R, and this is minus I omega square because this is del square of del t square. So first derivative gives minus I omega, then again second derivative minus I omega, so minus I omega square e to the power minus I omega t is equal to 0, or e to the power minus I omega t is taking common here, del square E of R then plus omega square by b square E of R is equal to 0. Since e to the power minus I omega t not equal to 0, so the bracket term is equal to 0. So del square E of R plus omega square by V square E of R is equal to 0. So that equation implies del square E of R plus K square E of R is equal to 0. So this equation is Helmholtz equation. So it is same as that is harmonic oscillator. So solution is same as that of harmonic oscillator. So its solution is E of R is equal to E0 e to the power plus minus I K dot R, where E0 is a constant vector. Then E of RT, is equal to E of R is that is E0 e to the power plus minus I K dot R into e to the power minus I omega T. This can be written as E0 e to the power I plus minus K dot R minus omega T. Similarly, we can write B of RT. B of RT is equal to B0 e to the power I plus minus K dot R minus omega T. Now, in equation 4, E of RT is equal to E0 e to the power I K dot R minus omega T. It represents a plane wave propagating forward direction. And E of RT is equal to E0 e to the power minus I into minus K dot R minus omega T. So this equation represents a plane wave propagating backward direction. Hence, for electromagnetic wave propagating in forward direction, we have E of RT is equal to E0 e to the power I K dot R minus omega T, and B of RT is equal to B0 e to the power I K dot R minus omega T. So these are the two equations that represents plane wave propagating a homogeneous non-conducting or dielectric medium. A plane wave is defined as a wave whose phase is the same at a given instant at all points on each plane perpendicular to the specified direction. So we consider a plane wave like this. Suppose it is propagating along this direction. This is the direction. This is called propagation vector K. Its magnitude is K, and unit vector along this direction is that is u cap. This is propagation vector. It points in the direction of propagation of the wave. We consider a point here At this point, electric field is E and magnetic field is B. Its position vector is, that is, R. So phase on each point on this plane is constant, and the wave is moving with velocity, that is Vp. That velocity is called phase velocity. Phase velocity. The velocity of motion of this EQ phase surface is called phase velocity. A constant phase implies that is K dot R minus omega T is equal to constant. K dot R minus omega T, this is constant. Now we take the projection of R in the direction of K. This is the projection, and this projection is represented by symbol Xi. So K dot R, that is, suppose this is some angle, and if this angle is theta, then K dot R equal to KR cos theta, and R cos theta is, that is, Xi. So we can write K Xi minus omega T is equal to constant, where Xi is the projection of position vector R in the K direction. Let us differentiate this equation. So K d xi by dt minus omega dt by dt is 1, and derivative of constant is 0, or K d xi by dt is written as, that is, Vp minus omega is equal to 0. Here Vp equal to d xi by dt is called the phase velocity. It's called the phase velocity of the wave, or Vp equal to omega by K. And we have K equal to omega by V. So V is 1 by square root of epsilon mu. So that is omega square root of epsilon mu. So Vp is equal to omega by K, and K is omega epsilon mu. So this is 1 by square root of epsilon mu, which is equal to V. That is the phase velocity. And this can be written as, that is, C by square root of epsilon r mu r. So epsilon r is relative permittivity, epsilon by epsilon 0, and mu r is the relative permeability, that is mu by mu naught. Now, what is the wavelength of the wave? Wavelength, that is lambda. It is the distance over which a point on an EQ phase moves during the period T. So lambda is equal to Vp into T. T is the period. So Vp equal to omega by K into T, and omega is 2 pi by T. Omega t equal 2 pi, so 2 pi by K. Here K is called wave number, and K vector is the propagation vector. So K is the magnitude of propagation vector. So this is about plane wave solution, phase velocity, and wavelength of electromagnetic wave. Thank you for watching.